Hey, Crunchyroll, you got them events yet or what?
Hi, I'm Lace and welcome back to another Princess Connect video. Today, I'm going to be talking about events because there's actually quite a lot that's going on, and especially with the recent 2x Grotto event, I wanted to share some of the details on like how events or like the future ones, especially how they work and my thoughts on how they affect you and what you do. So I'm talking like how it makes you spend your money, you know what I'm saying? So without further ado, let's just get into it. So there are like login events, 2x events, events like the ones that we, you know, that we'll be focusing on today. So the ones with the stories and the clearing the bosses and this and that, clan battles and Lunar Tower. So I'm not going to be talking about clan battles or Lunar Tower. I've covered clan battles before. I've got a whole video on it. I will cover clan battles as they come out with the different strategies that you can do to beat the bosses and stuff like that. But for now, that's it. Same deal for Lunar Tower. I'll cover it when it's getting close. So not going to spend another second on it. So let's start with login events. Very straightforward. You log in, you get stuff. Sometimes you even get pulls. For example, you might actually be able to like pull 10 times a day or 10 days straight, which is pretty crazy. Let's just hope that like Crunchyroll follows this too. And again, I obviously have my doubts because that's originally like a really Cygames thing to do, but like guys, let's just stay hopeful before crucifying the game. Let's give it a chance. All right, let's move on to the 2x events. So for example, we have like these 2x Grotto events that we're having right now. So I'm going to generalize them a little bit and just call them 2x events, even though they're not all 2x events. Why? Because it actually goes on rotation between different parts of the game. So that actually includes stuff like 2x normal stage drops, so that's equipment and mana, 1.5x EXP on stamina expenditure, 1.5x EXP on like the event quests, 2x hard stage drops. Yes, you heard that right. That is shard farming. Oh baby, that is what I'm talking about. 2x grotto drop, like the one that we're having now. It's 2x dungeon mana, where you only get 2x the mana from dungeon because the 2x drops is from a paid thing. And future content, where we have 2x hearts and orbs, which are used for like the unique equipments and 6 stars, as well as the 2x gold memory fragments, which are also used for 6 stars. Eventually it does become like a set rotation between all of these, but at this point just know that they exist and that these are like the main possibilities. So let's start with the normal stage 2x equipment and mana drop. I can't justify refreshing for this because there is just so much other better things to refresh on. You should not be like starved of equipment, and if you're looking for mana, you should probably actually just get like the paid monthly. But the most important one for the normal stages is actually the 1.5x EXP. So this is probably where a lot of people are going to start spending those gemmies on refreshing. Me personally, I've only touched refreshing like 3x or something like in my total account. So if you're ever going to refresh EXP because like you need to get that player level up, then like that is the time. So getting more EXP actually means that you can push more levels, you can push your progress, you can push more like stages, you can like get more further in like arena and clan battle. And why is all that important? Because it actually increases your gem earning capacity. And just remember guys, and I say this like every freaking video, you have to spend a little bit of money to make money. Spending those gems is kind of like an investment where you can like actually hold higher ranks, and therefore you'll get more gems so that you can actually hold those ranks, and then it all makes sense, right? You know, you spend it and then you make it, and then you spend it and then you make it. Over time, hopefully you'll be making more than you're spending. And this is particularly true for clan battle because of like you're going from 500 to 4.5k. Like that's a big variance. Just need to make sure that everyone else in your clan is on the same page. The next one is hard stage drop. So you could refresh the hard stage attempts. The main justification for this one is like if you're close to acquiring like a unique equipment or like a 5-star or 6-star or something like that, that could ultimately help you push in arena or clan battle or something else, then yeah, go for it, I guess. But otherwise, I think it's like you could and you could not for this one. You could also refresh to be farming more of the actual shards. Like for example, you might only be farming like 8 of the stages. You might end up like want to farming like 16 of them. Honestly, I probably would rather refresh like wide than like focus in on one of them, unless again, you're going to be like hitting a unique equipment or something. 2x grotto drops. So there is a case to get the additional grotto attempts from the shop, and the grotto attempts, they actually last for either 7 days or 30 days. The event itself we saw last for about 9 to 10 days. So you could theoretically just like pop on that 7 days one. Obviously from a pure efficiency point of view, the 30 days one is a better one for like a cost efficiency. So you're getting more a dollar that you're spending. However, if you're trying to keep to like a lower budget, the 7 days one is not bad. Even bigger, however, is that, and I have previously talked about this, it's just that I don't value those grotto attempts because grotto just gives you mana and EXP and to an extent skip tickets, right? If you just get the daily jewel pack, AKA the monthly, like you'll be getting double dungeon rewards in which you get more mana. You can turn mana into EXP pots, but you can't turn EXP pots into mana. So that just makes mana more versatile. So to summarize, if you're a dolphin, you could definitely go for the additional grotto attempts, like to take advantage of the 2x grottos. But if you're okay with like the characters, you're being focused, you're being targeted and not leveling like everybody, then you should be okay, especially if you get the monthly 2x dungeon mana event. So this means that you don't get the 2x drops. You only get the 2x mana because the 2x drops actually comes from like the paid monthly. I don't think there is too much that you can do here, like just proceed see it as normal. And as for future content such as like 2x hearts and 2x orbs, whatever, I'll cover that another day. I want to keep this video short. It's already not very short. Now let's get into the real juicy stuff, the events kind of thing. So again, your events are like your classical events. There's a story, there are stages to clear, and then you kill some bosses and then you trade it for some rewards, something like that, right? Now to summarize it even further, first you got to push the event quest. So it's like quest 1 to quest 15. As you finish these quests, you get boss tickets and you use these boss tickets to challenge the bosses at the end of the entire map. If you're able to kill the bosses, then you get medals or certificates or coins or whatever it is. It's just another currency that you can then turn into boxes. So those boxes are like, there's like 1 to 5 boxes. And then when you get to the boxes, you actually just clear it out for rewards using the coins. Do note that the boxes are RNG, but eventually you should be able to clear out the entire box if you wish to. So let me take that a little bit further. So what does it look like? So the normal event map is going to be like stage 1 to stage 15. And then at the very end of stage 15, after you finish that, you'll be able to fight a normal boss, which is normally situated like in the middle of the map. So it actually really looks like a lot like this. After you finish the normal boss, you can then move on to the next stage in which there's like a hard mode or something, which also kind of looks like this, to be honest. And then there's another hard boss that's just like sitting there. So you have to finish the first 15 stages to challenge the normal boss, and then you have to finish the next 5 hard stages to challenge the hard boss. Only after you finish the hard boss can you actually verse the very hard boss. And the very hard boss you can only clear once a day. So in the hard map of the event, you can actually farm the memory shards as well. So it's kind of like, it's almost exactly like this. However, the only thing that's different is that you can't actually refresh the limit of it. So if there's a 5 stages, you can only get up to like 15 shards or whatever it is a day. Also, depending on where you're at, you might not be able to finish the very hard boss efficiently, but like at least challenge him once a day so that you can gauge like if you can beat him or not, or like how far you are. Just a minor spoiler for the Hatsune event that we're getting first. I think the recommended levels are like level 20 for the normal stages, level 30 for the hard stages, and level 50 for the very hard stage. And that's easy. You can do that in like one day. But let's talk about the rewards. So let's use this one for example. So again, like I said, there are going to be like a whole bunch of boxes, right? So you clear the first box and then you move on to the next, and then you clear that box and you move on to the next. That's actually not entirely true. So actually all you need to really clear is the red lined one here. So it's actually the memory piece here. So if I'm on the first box, I just started and then I lucked out and I got 2x the Shiori memory pieces 5x, then I can actually move on to the second box. However, that is not what I recommend you do. What you probably should at least do is also go for these Goddess Secret Stones, which are actually just the divine amulets. If you have a quick look through this, you'll see that these numbers, like, it's actually changing. So the further down you go, the more likely it is that you get trash items. Depending on how you feel, you may go for like an early reset. For me personally, I'm probably going to be looking at getting about like the first 3 items and then moving on to the next one, because like the other ones don't really interest me too much. However, this one's really interesting, the random equipment box, which is really, really cool. So it actually scales with your level. So if you're a higher level, then you have like a higher chance of getting gold equipment, for example. But again, going back to it, you only need to clear the red lined one to move on to the next box. So there are actually like 4 or 5 of these limited boxes. And then after you get to the 5th one, then you start going with the unlimited box. The unlimited box still has the jewels and divine amulets, so it's okay. But like all in all, you should be getting a lot from these events. If you can't do anything else, at least clear up to the 4th box and get like, try to get like the first 3. If not, like at least the memory pieces, which you have to do anyway, and the Goddess Secret Stones, aka the divine amulets. So as each boss comes out, I'll be making more and more guides to actually like supplement these events, because like there are some like strategies that you can employ to kill these bosses more easily. So for example, this guy here is Ziz. So as you can see, his UB is actually like a large amount of physical damage to like all enemies, which is us, so we're the enemies actually. So for example, what would work here is like Shizuru or like physical tanks like Miyako and just stuff like that. It's just these kinds of like teachings that I will go through when we get there. Other than that, I think that pretty much wraps up the event itself. So let's have a look at like kind of the timeline at what's going to happen. So as I said, again, the Hatsune event should probably be like one of the first ones, if not the first one. And in this event, we'll be able to farm a whole bunch of Hatsune and Shiori shards, and then we can move on. So it's not always a 3-star. You see, we've got Mimi and we've got Misogi here, but all in all, it's like pretty cool. Also, one thing I forgot to talk about is actually these guys here. So you can see this is actually a new unit, right? This is Summer Kokoro. So this is what we call a welfare unit, when an event actually gives out a unit for free. Welfare units are usually obtained after you finish the first 15 normal stages, and the welfare unit's shard, which is this one right here, is usually farmable in the hard stages in that same event. But honestly, that should give you like a pretty good rundown as to like what to expect from events. There isn't too much more to talk about, except like, you know, guys, just have fun with it. I'll leave a link down below, but I'll probably just like put it into like my little special nerd document so that you guys have easy access to it. It doesn't tell you everything, but it's kind of good enough, right? With that being said, that's kind of like the end of the video. If you made it here, thank you so much. You already know what time it is. It's secret message time. Secret message today is please give event CR. Man, I am so ready for events to start. I am so, so, so friggin' ready. If you could drop that secret message down in the comments below, I would really, really appreciate it. It tells me that you've actually made it to this part of the video, aka the end. And that's just incredibly hype because I spent a lot of hours actually doing the research and being able to pull all of this together for you guys. Otherwise, there's nothing left to do except if this video has helped you, like, follow, subscribe. You already know what it is. Come join the Discord if you want to just like trash talk a little or if you need some help. And come catch a stream if you can. I stream every freaking day. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.